As you all know that Shraddhs are still going on, similarly we are also following the same rules which we did on the first day, that is offering tarpan and feeding to mother cow. I want to tell those people who do not know about tarpan that it is a type of method in which we make a mixture of Ganga water and milk and offer small amounts of black sesame, barley and rice grains to our ancestors. And those people who do not know about Ganga water, I want to tell them that the Ganga water is a sacred water in the custom of Hindus. Like my father is no more in this world, so we have kept his pitcher and a garland in his pitcher and a lamp of pasteurized butter or sesame oil has been kept in front of him to pay homage to him. Ganga water and basil leaves have been kept in a peat or earthen pot so that when he feel thirsty, he would have drink the Ganga water, and an incense stick has been lit to keep away the bad shadows. According to the scriptures, the first tarpan should be towards the east for the gods, second tarpan should be held towards north for humans, and the third tarpan should be held towards south for our ancestors. And now it's time to go to the cowshed and feed them. It's more fun to do this method with my mother every day. In this way, we have become closer to each other. And the things that I have not learned till now I am learning everything from her. I am very thankful to her for that I have been learning all this. Today's weather is rainy, as you could see, so today we thought that we will go to the temple and cowshed without slippers. But my mother's feet are very delicate. I mean, she has prayed many times, sometimes to Krishna, sometimes to Goddess Manimai for our family, and she has been living without slippers for a year. For a year, how her feet have become dry. My mother also has pain in her knees. She is not able to walk much. The bones of her legs have become very fragile. Now she is 49 and the mother of 3 young adults. It's natural to have pain, and hence if she walks every day in this name of temple or puja worship, she will remain active. Yes, because this is how she do her exercise and worship in the same time. As soon as the tarpan process is completed, we offer the same tarpan water to the ficus tree or sacred fig. Now we are going to feed the cow. We don't have a mother cow, so we could feed someone else's cow. If anyone kept the cow at their home, we could feed their cow if we know them. Or we could also feed any mother cow who is wandering on the road. Thank you.
बहुत मुश्किल है
नारायण नारायण
हरि बोल
हरि बोल।
अरे ऐसे कर इतने लंबे लंबे पैर है मेरे लिए।
आपकी कृपा से सब काम हो रहा आराम से आना आपको रिकॉर्ड
बंद नहीं होता मेरा कैमरा मुझे पसंद नहीं बंद करना
वो तो जब बैटरी खत्म होने लग जाती तब करना पड़ता है। So this is the second day of Shraddh. We don't have cow or buffalo, so we are here in another house of other house cow. As soon as we have fed food to the mother cow, we are going towards the temple to perform the worship. As we reached the temple, we saw that the gate was locked, but no problem. God has locked one door so that the other door needs to be opened. Then as usual, we kept turpan water and curd in an earthen glass and kept that under the ficus tree.
लगता है हमें अपने पितर के पेड़ के नीचे फिर वो
वहीं पे ठीक था ना, फिर इतना दूर आने की क्या जरूरत है, चलते वहीं। The idol you are seeing is Shanidev. We offer some water to him and also revolve around the ficus tree. We revolve 5 to 7 times around the tree. We light the lamp and incense sticks. After that, we went to home to have food, and while returning home from the temple, we met a little boy whose name is Shivam. How cute he is. Just look at him. He is so cute, right?